Mechanical Pros. We are in MRG's office. We're looking at our VRV Live lab. And we're going to be talking about branch selector boxes and proper wiring and communication. Brian, tell me what we got going on here.
Yeah, so what we've got here is a branch selector box. This is for our VRV IV system that we use for all of our training. What you see here is you've got three pipes coming into this box. That would be our liquid pipe, our gas pipe, and our mixed gas pipe. The purpose of a branch selector box, I like to tell people to think of it as a reversing valve living in that box. It's going to change the flow of refrigerant, whether we've got a demand for heating or cooling off of which indoor unit that's attached to that box, whatever they're calling for. This certain setup here, I've got three indoor units tied onto this box. We could have multiple heating and cooling simultaneously. One unit could be heating, the other can be cooling. All that happens inside that branch selector box with changing of valve positions, determining whether we're getting suction gas back or we're providing hot gas to the units. One other thing I wanted to talk about today is what we see in the field when we run into either a startup or maybe a callback once we get into a change of seasons, and that would be due to miswiring on the communication loop from the branch selector box to the associated indoor units. So basically what we've got is two pipes leaving that box going to each indoor unit, and then we've got a comm wire that leaves the box off of that refrigerant port and ties into the indoor unit that it's attached to. If those wirings get crossed, every unit's running in the cool mode, you'll never know you've got an issue because everybody's cooling. When you run into that change of season, that's when those cross wires will show up. You think your unit's calling for cooling, it'll actually be running in the heat mode. A lot of confusion in wiring, a lot of time tracking down and fixing those problems. But real quick, I'll kind of jump up here and show you the terminals and how easy it is to wire it the correct way, but also how easy it is to miss that. So I'll jump up here real quick and show you that. So we've got a few terminal strips on here, low voltage. This is our wiring coming from our condensing unit that's talking to this branch selector box. Our outdoor unit has a comm loop that goes across the branch selector box. If I had multiple boxes, I would daisy chain off of this comm port and go to my next box. This comm port down here is my indoor units. So this is a four port box. I'd have port A, B, C, or D. If I've got my piping leaving on port A, that's where my comm wiring for that indoor unit leaves to land. If I mix it up right here, that's where the problem's gonna happen. Again, when you start this gear up, it all starts in the cooling mode. If the ambient temperature is above 85 degrees, I cannot force it into the heat mode. So if we're doing a startup in the middle of the summer, you're not gonna catch this unless you've got the time to go to each individual unit and check all of those wiring connections here. So does that really happen in the real world? Do you ever have enough time to do all that when the job's always been installed? Typically not. So this really needs to be caught on the install end. Always make sure when you leave this terminal, the best way to do this, if this is port A or B, whichever one, strap it off to the piping that leaves that port and it'll go right to the correct indoor unit. When that doesn't happen and the wiring gets run after the piping, that's when we typically see the problems. Again, very hard to catch it if it's the middle of summer or if you're doing a startup and the unit's running in full cool. So cause a lot of callbacks, can cause a lot of comfort issues, can give this product a bad name when it's really a solid product, but it's all about the install. If you install it right, it's going to be a good job and it's always going to work correctly. So that's the big thing I wanted to talk about, the branch selector boxes. There is one other thing real quick to touch on is dip switches. If I have ports that I'm not going to use, so this is a four port box, I'm only using a few of the ports. I've got a blank port. I've got to go turn a dip switch and tell the box there's nothing connected to that port. Again, we cover this all in our startup training. We like to get to these when we do our startup to verify dip switch settings. But one thing we have trouble with when it's the heat of the summer is the comm wiring going to the indoor unit. So super critical to catch that every time. If you get it right the first time, you'll never have any problems. This unit will be rock solid.
Hey, if you do get a comm error, Brian, mm-hmm. What's the typical error code you'd probably
typically see on that? It's gonna be a U type of error code. It may be a U4, something like that, saying communication is off between the indoor unit and outdoor unit. When we see the wiring switched, you typically don't get that code. What you get is units running in the wrong mode of operation, and then that can also cause mechanical failure down the road. You can get liquid flood back to your compressors when that starts happening if it's not addressed quickly. So something as simple as just landing a wire on the wrong terminal can cause a lot of headaches down the road. So we always want to avoid that and spend those extra few minutes just to make sure you got it in the right spot.
That's good. That's great information. Thanks for joining us here on Mechanical Pros. Hit that like, hit that subscribe, and we'll catch you next time.